Hola, hola amigos, bienvenidos a nuestro canal Más Urbano TV, donde encuentras lo más urbano.
Buenas tardes familia, vengo con una encuesta hoy así rápida. ¿Quién es peor o qué es peor? ¿El egoísmo de los seres humanos o la avaricia de las grandes empresas? Veo mucha gente diciendo o hablando acerca de la inconsciencia de muchos seres humanos en los centros de abastecimiento, las tiendas de cadena, los supermercados, porque hay muchas personas que están llevando mucha cantidad de productos y están dejando las estanterías vacías, y otros se están quedando sin nada, ¿cierto? Entonces a mí me da a pensar varias cosas. ¿A quién juzgar? ¿Al ser humano, que es egoísta por naturaleza, que desde pequeño le enseñaron que el que más tiene es el más poderoso, que el que más gana es el más exitoso, que el más rico es el más popular y que el que menos tiene es el perdedor? ¿Cierto? Un ejemplo, hay una persona, un ejemplo más humano, digámoslo así. Hay una persona que tiene dos hijos pequeños y los tiene que alimentar, no tiene comida en la nevera, pero tiene dinero para comprar. Va a una tienda de cadena y ve la posibilidad de coger 10 pacas de leche, 5 cajas de huevos, 10 de arroz, azúcar, sal, todo lo necesario para alimentarse y alimentar a sus hijos. Va a pensar, no, solamente va a llevar una canasta de huevos, una bolsa de leche, porque hay personas que también tienen la necesidad. Unos recién casados, una persona de 20 años, una familia sin hijos, una persona de la tercera edad. No creo que vaya a pensar eso. Va a pensar en sus necesidades propias y en que tiene la posibilidad y el poder económico para hacerlo en este momento, ¿cierto? Entonces, ¿juzgaríamos al ser humano o juzgaríamos a las grandes empresas o tiendas de cadena por venderle a una sola persona 50 pacas de papel higiénico, 80 bolsas de leche, 30 de azúcar, 50 cajas de huevos, sabiendo que hay la necesidad para más personas que vienen en la fila, que se están quedando sin nada? Personas de la tercera edad, madres solteras con hijos recién nacidos, familias de 3, 4 personas. Hablaríamos de avaricia en las grandes cadenas, que solo quieren vender y piensan en su bolsillo y no les interesa la comunidad. ¿A quién juzgamos? ¿A la gente que tiene miedo, que tiene la posibilidad de comprar y de abastecerse, o a las grandes cadenas que piensan en vender y vender y vender y vender y vender? Yo creo que los dos están en su derecho y tienen algo de razón. El ser humano quisiera tener todo lo necesario para abastecerse, para alimentarse, para sobrevivir durante mucho tiempo y alimentar a sus seres queridos. Bien. Y las cadenas de almacenes también, su objetivo es vender y vender y vender. Por eso le invierten tanto a su publicidad, a sus almacenes, con empleados, con promociones, porque les interesa vender, ¿cierto? No juzgaría a ninguno de los dos. Pero sí pienso que las tiendas de cadena deberían poner un límite por persona para que todos puedan suplir sus necesidades. Cada persona, una paca de agua, una paca de papel higiénico, uno o dos jabones antibacteriales. Así nadie se va a quedar embalado. A la final ya todos sabemos el alcance que tenemos los seres humanos, y más en estos casos de caos, de miedo, donde empieza a reinar la supervivencia del más fuerte y el débil empieza a quedar aislado. El que menos posibilidades económicas tiene empieza a quedar aislado. No le sumamos más a esta problemática con críticas, con quejas, con juzgar. Y si tiene ese pensamiento, más bien váyase para un centro de abastecimiento si tiene la posibilidad económica de comprar y todavía le venden varias cosas. Entonces compre varias pacas de papel higiénico y llévele a alguien que no tenga la posibilidad de comprar, que no tenga el poder económico para comprar. Hay mucha gente en la calle que no tiene nada. Y yo creo que hacemos más. Y yo lo voy a hacer. Y los invito a que lo hagamos. En vez de estar criticando y juzgando, hagamos algo de verdad. De verdad que hay mucha gente que la está pasando mal y la va a pasar peor. Entonces no hablemos desde la comodidad de la casa y con la nevera llena y las estanterías llenas, porque estar del otro lado es muy difícil. Y yo en mi vida he estado con la nevera vacía y sé lo duro que es. Entonces hagamos algo de verdad y no estemos criticando en redes sociales. Salga y ayude a alguien. Muchos hablan y estoy seguro que tienen esas neveras y esas estanterías llenas. Y el ser humano piensa en sí mismo, eso está claro. Entonces no juzguemos. Y las tiendas de cadena de verdad, un límite para cada persona, para que todos puedan sobrevivir esto tan difícil. Sean más conscientes y no le vendan a una sola persona 10.000 pacas de leche y 20, 50 litros de agua. Porque hay mucha gente que también necesita, todos necesitamos el agua. Amén y Dios los bendiga a todos, familia. Vamos a superarla.
Hey.
Hello, sir. How are you?
Doing good. How about you?
Good. What's your name?
Jonathan.
Jonathan. And where are you from, Jonathan?
What's that? I think you're glitching out.
Where are you
Near the
from,
gym.
Jonathan?
So I live in Columbia, South Carolina.
South Carolina. And what do you know? Can you hear me, brother?
I can hear you in and out.
So we're going to move on from Jonathan. We're going to move on to who are we going to move on with? Let's see, let's see, let's see. Okay, so sorry, guys. Ben,
Yo, what's good, bro?
so you've been talking about this coronavirus for months now, right?
Yeah.
What can you tell the people online who are wondering what they should do, how serious this is, and what precautions they should be taking?
I mean, it's really serious, you know what I'm saying? It's like, for the most part, someone like you, who's in good health and everything else, you could fight this off. And if, you don't have any pre-existing, conditions like heart disease, any kind of health issues, 2 weeks and either it could be super mild, it could feel like a little bit of a flu, or it could feel really bad and your lungs could shut down and it affect your entire respiratory. Someone like me, who's in his late 40s, or someone, like in their 50s, 60s, who's not in great health or anything else, it could just shut them down completely. And then they'd be in ICU and they would need, assistance through an IV and everything else. One thing I read about the people in China and the people in Korea that they've been using vitamin C, no joke, high dosage, high milligram vitamin C, and it's been cutting down sickness time, even with older people, to like 8 days. Some people are
I
getting
got a
out in
drip
10 days,
today.
6 days.
I got high dose vitamin C today.
Yeah, man, it's good stuff.
Have you
But
done that yet?
realistically, I mean, it's simple for right now, because we're so behind and Americans just, they feel so privileged, you just gotta stay indoors and quarantine. My oldest son, he has respiratory illness, so I'm really scared for him to get it because the chances of him living, is not good with him to get it. So we tested him last week because he got sick. But you gotta remember, some of these people, they're reckless, they're not thinking about it. Then they bring it home to their grandparents, they bring it home to one of their friends that's a smoker. I got a friend of mine who's 38 years old and he got it and his lungs are shut down, so he's in Tarzana right now dealing with it.
Well, Ben, I just want to say thank you. I want to say thank you for bringing awareness to people and letting people know how serious this is. I'm going to keep talking with different people, but thank you so much for your insight,
Come on,
Ben.
I love you, bro. All good. I love you, bro.
Love you, bro. All right. Scooter,
what are we doing here?
What do you know about the, what insight can you tell people about what's going on right now and what they can do to protect themselves or to protect their loved ones? That's the question.
I think, look, the majority of people that follow you are in an age range where the chance of this virus killing them is actually very small. But everybody in your age range has people that they love, whether it be their parents or their grandparents or a friend who's diabetic or someone like you who has Lyme disease, who is immunocompromised. And 50 to 80% of people who get this virus don't show symptoms, and that's why it's traveling so fast. So when you and your friends are hanging out and saying, oh, we're going to meet up, we're going to do like a little party at the house or something, and you're hanging out and you have a couple drinks, and then you go back to your families, you might feel perfectly fine, but you're putting everyone in your family at risk. And my favorite thing I saw is somebody wrote, my grandparents went to war to fight something. All I need to do is sit my ass at home.
Yeah.
You know, and I think what everyone really needs to be doing is taking in consideration, not themselves, but people that they love. You know, you love Nick Jonas.
Love him.
You love some Nick Jonas.
Love him.
Nick Jonas has diabetes.
Yeah.
You know, like, you love Nick Jonas, you're going to keep your ass at home. I love
absolutely.
You.
Absolutely.
You know, you have Lyme disease.
My grandfather also has diabetes, so yeah.
So, you know, I think people just need to understand, like, this is showing us that, you know, a virus doesn't understand borders. A virus doesn't understand, you know, anything, but this is a human person, and I'm going in there. And right now, the blessing in this is that young kids aren't affected. So I got three young kids, and I don't have to worry as much about them. But I am doing my part. I'm completely quarantined.
Awesome.
I've made sure I have food for my family. And,
awesome.
You know, what I think people can be doing, you posted and I posted it. There's a lot of kids in inner city areas and rural areas that really depend on public school service for their food.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Save the Children is doing some amazing stuff. Baby to Baby is doing amazing stuff. And what people really need to be doing, if they have the means, is being able to donate to make sure that these kids have meals and that, you know, people have the proper ability to feed their children in a time where, you know, so many people are one disaster away from not having an income. And right now we're in a real disaster, and a lot of people are going to be hurting beyond a disease financially. And we got to look out for each other. So I think it's really great that you're doing this. People need to wash their hands. They need to stay 6 feet away from each other.
Mm-hmm.
And if, you know, Do your part, stay at home, and honor the people that have to work, the people in hospitals, doctors, nurses, you know, people who have to go out there, and don't flood them with sick people because you're being irresponsible. Do your part, because right now we can handle this virus, but we need to slow it down so our healthcare can actually handle it. And I think what you're doing by raising awareness is awesome, and people just need to spread the word of, yeah, it might not be here, but you know when it's there? When it affects someone that you love.
Mm-hmm.
And if that day comes, you're not going to like it. So I think we all just need to sit at home and realize that, you know, this is going to affect the entire world, and we're just getting started.
Mm-hmm.
This is probably going to affect, just in America alone, it's probably going to affect 150 million Americans by the end of the year. And we see what's going on in Italy, and, you know, we've seen what's happened in China. Now we're seeing every other country around the world. Mm-hmm. And I think people should just do what they can to be supportive of each other, put whatever BS you got out to the side, and we all need to come together as a humanity.
Mm-hmm. Thanks, Scooter.
Love you, bud. Great
Love
job.
You. Bye.
Bye.
Wise words from Scooter Braun. What was this in here?
Why did you do that?